Yeah, absolutely. I think, you know, the first thing I look at after a game when I get the sheet is my face-offs. And, you know, before every game I'll watch draws right before we go out, just so it's fresh in my mind. And if something's not working, I'll rewatch during the intermissions. Yeah, it's definitely something I take pride in. You know, I've been fortunate in Nashville. I was taking a lot of strong side draws. We'd have another guy, maybe Sissons would take him on the right. I'd take him on the left, which definitely helps your percentage. But I think either side, I'm pretty confident.
So when you go check that stat sheet, are you checking to make sure that the stat guys had it right? Or
yeah,
you know.
Like, I'm
you
usually know. Counting in my head as the game goes. That's the one thing I'm like, you know, because it matters. You know, by the end of a game, coaches are checking, you know, with the guys up top. How are our centers doing? Who's going to take this draw? And a face-off you always want to take as a center, you know, those late-game draws. So I'm usually always on top of it. I know when I suck, I'll tell the assistant, hey, I can't win a draw tonight. I'm, you know, 1-8, and it's just one of those nights. But, yeah, try to stay on top of it. You know, hopefully it's reflected correctly in the stats after. But can't control that. Just, just do my work, do my homework on the other guys, and just bear down.
You ever chat with your wingers? I always say, like, let's say I take 10 draws a night, and I'm going to be 50%. And it's you win five, I win five. Wingers, if you can steal me one, I go from 50 to 60%. All of a sudden, I'm the best face-off guy in the league, but I need your help. You ever talk to him like
that's
that?
That's so true, yeah. Yeah, and obviously you've played with enough wingers that some guys are awesome at jumping in for you. Some guys, you know, don't do it as much. Definitely, I think face-offs are more of a line or a team stat in some cases than a center. Obviously, the center's the one taking them, but if your wings are jumping in and winning draws for you, it's always a good feeling. I know when I line up on the wing, I want to, you know, knock it back for the center, knowing how he feels, wants a little help. Well, timing. I think, you know, the linesmen play a big part in it. There's some linesmen who are pretty strict and won't let you move. And when you get kind of a good rapport with one linesman and you know his timing, you know when he's going to drop it, you kind of cheat a little bit. I personally don't throw my skate in there. It makes me so frustrated. But skate guys are guys that are usually at the top of the leaderboard. So trying to battle them is always an adventure every night. Yeah, for me, it's timing the linesman's drop, timing the puck, trying to meet the puck when it hits. Switching, you know, whether I'm sweeping, whether I'm going over the top, whether I'm tying up, things like that. That there's a lot more that goes into it than just getting there and throwing your stick in.